Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace be, the eye I first believed. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. And life.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Let me even under this circumstance to say a graceful afternoon to all of you who have gathered in, as we normally and traditionally would say, to allow feeling and to be failure to a brother, a friend, a father, a husband, Lord Michael John, the late Lord Michael John. To what we want to be today, we not here to put you in a compromising situation. We here to have a time of refreshment. We here to remind ourselves that God is in charge. Amen. Despite the given circumstances, God is in charge, and He do it on His behalf. Amen. I want to invite you to stand at this time as we call upon the name of the Lord, because certainly, if ever there was a time we need to feel His warmth around us, I believe that in these challenging times of life, hallelujah, that everything seems to be spiraling out of control. When we abandon God, everything is under control, because I realize this afternoon that certainly He is the beginning and He is the end. We need Him as the Alpha and the Omega, the God above all gods and Lord above all lords. May I remind somebody here today that He has a name, and His name is Jesus. Hallelujah. Can we give Him a raise today? Can we give Him a shout? Hallelujah. Father and our God, we come before You today. We come here another time, God, to draw strength. Lord, we look to You. We do as the psalmist says,
the disease, Lord George.
feed me up today. Let it be a time of refreshing. Let it be a time where God will reflect and say, God said to me, in spite of you've been good to us. We thank you for life today. We are not rejoicing over the loss of Lawrence's life, but we are thankful that you've preserved us until we get the key of this funeral today. So have your way even now. Let's go remain a part of the service. Lord God, may we run to your glory and honor today. We give you glory and honor. Hallelujah. So we are trying to follow the program. I'm glad you're here today. And to lend support. Amen. We are here today. I feel honored today being on this group another time. Amen. Amen. Brings back memory that indeed we are our brother's keeper. Pastor is not around, he's no more. Amen. Amen. Can I just be a little naughty today? Can I just be a little naughty? I like being naughty sometimes. The late LMS Murray said, if they take it out, it would have been a waste because I'm not a Rastaman. Jesus, but I'm not a Rastaman today. I'm not a preacher today. So God is good all the time. God is good. He's not here to compound the situation by seeking to add sorrow to sorrow. But we're here to bring your faith today. We're here to lift your faith today. That knowing, even when the songwriter would have suffered the loss of his family, his household, his word, and he was going on a missionary journey, when he heard the news, he consoled himself because God gave him the strength. He said, it is well with my soul. Amen. So at this time, let me invite the worship team to come. Amen. We're going to sing, we're going to shout. Amen. I have the privilege of at least spending some time with the Lord. Amen. We are the community center here. We were busy. Amen. In the group center and everything else. Amen. So I believe that you have had enough time. Amen. In spite of circumstances. Because when we cannot quite understand people, God understands. Because he's the creator and sustainer of us all. So I think I'll be talking about who I'm talking about again later on in the future. So let me decrease at this time and allow a sister, a friend to come today and believe in time of worship.
Because of his faithfulness, because of his grace and his strength. Alright, so we're going to start off by singing, "What are you calling to wife? Open the eyes of the blind." Amen. I want you to sing with me. I want you to clap your hands. Amen. We celebrate the life of the late George. Amen. We're not celebrating death, we're celebrating his life.
Yeah, that's right.
Amen. His life. What are you calling to wife? Open the eyes of the blind. There's no one like you. There's no one like you.
Yes, he is. God, my
name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. 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 In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord God. Thank you, Jesus. I surrender, Lord, to you.
Jesus, we give you thanks, and we give you
praise in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Come on, put your hands together for the Lord today in the mighty name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Before I hand you over to Pastor, I'm going to sing this chorus. My Jesus poured it around. He poured it around for me. Amen. He poured it around. My Jesus poured it around. He poured it around.
Hallelujah.
This is the grandson.
I saw as an editor your manhood. Let everyone know this song, right? So just sing along. Alright. Made of you, standing here. Come on, I can't hear you. Not knowing how we get through this time, but holding on to faith, you know best. Nothing can catch you by surprise. You got this. We can win. You wrap us in your arms and step in, and everything we need you supply. You got this in control, and now we know that you are. He's making a way this morning. Well, and it looked as if it was over. You made a way. One more time, you made a way. You made a way. And now we're here. Good. Only because you made a way. Because of you and nothing we've done to deserve the love and mercy you show. Your grace was strong enough to pick us up, cause you made a way. When our backs were against the wall and it looked as if it was over, standing here only because
it.
One more time. I'm standing here only because you made a wish. You made a wish. You made a wish. This morning, God is making a wish for you. You made a wish. He's making a wish in your workplace. You made. You make a way. You just have to trust him. Don't know how, but you did it. Make a way. Come on. Don't know how, but you did it. Make a way. Don't know how, but you did it. Don't know how, but you did it. Don't know how, but you did it. Because you made, I will clap in here only because you made a way. You move mountains, you cause grass to fall, which have power. You perform it. Come on, come on, come on. There is nothing that's impossible. Because you've been away. You move mountains. You move mountains. You move mountains. You move mountains. You cause walls to fall. You cause walls to fall. You cause walls. Come on, walls. Walls is falling this morning. Mountain. I have a piece of for you. You move mountains. Hey, hey. Yes, you move mountains. Hey. Mountains are moving. Shadows are breaking. Mountains are moving. Shadows are breaking. Mountains are moving, showers are breaking, but you move mountains, you cause walls to fall, it's your power, you perform miracles, it is nothing that's impossible.
You are anticipating a mighty gain for us. Well, you read through and what I understood prophetically and profoundly is declared himself. Amen. Because I prayed and I moved to prophetically and understand what was happening. He was prophetically saying, he moved on there. He caused walls to fall. He had gone past the ordinary level and he had experienced the extraordinary in decreeing and declaring things, though they are not as who they are. And that's how we move, amen. Amen. For what the my God. I've got to get it. Don't give me a lot of space, you know. At this time, amen, amen, I'm supposed to say, at this time, I think we want the truth. Talk about me first, the name of Jesus, I'm here already with a mind. So, you know, sitting there, the minister, the main Lord, and then I noticed Lord Michael. Even the whole public, Michael, that name, Michael. That name Michael is. Michael is the angel who wounded the dead. Michael the archangel. Defeated Satan. The man was a fighter. I remember the boy growing up because we were neighbors. And he had a dream. And he said, teach that dream to fight. With that dream to fly. I remember that vividly. Because what we do is celebrating his life. Amen. So I remember that vividly. You know, we was teaching that dream to fly, that dream, you know, was crossing him. And he would be bumping the wind, that dream flying and coming. Amen. But the man was a fighter. He did not show no arms. And I believe he could have said, like Paul the Apostle, he had fought in the fight. Amen. So we are indeed grateful to him. Glad because I would have spent, I would have had some time with him as a little one growing up. I mean, football field, maybe you don't even know that was a football. But at least you try to think. He had a different football group than everybody else. He had a string front one with a stick in front. He had a different group. So when the guys started all the banana kick and all the things, he would give a good toe punch. Amen. So those are some of the wise things, those are some of the fun times. Remember sharing his gift. We were even in crusades and all these things. As I said again, I have learned one thing around ministry for quite some time. And I do not go down the road saying that you know that man has gone to hell. That woman has gone to hell. Now I'm not in that position to say that. Because at the end of the day, it's God who has defined sin. And that God knows the heart of man. We may judge outwardly, but God judges the heart. Amen. So I remember those one time with him, and at least in parts of the crusade, he was much of a helper. That's when myself and Pastor Army were in the pavilion center here, the community center. He was there at it. Amen. So, to believe, family said, Calamence is from the Jones family and from the church of which I preside over. Amen. Faith renewed apostolic prophetic center. We express our heartfelt condolences to the family. And even in this your time of loss, that God continue to strike you and enrich you with his word. God bless you. Who's next?
I am here to pay tribute to my uncle, Uncle Roger. I remember as a little girl, I remember my $50. I remember getting my $100. I remember getting a drop from him. And anytime I'm on the road, he always never called me by my name. I can't remember. But I always use my niece, but he's always there. And today, I would like to thank God for his life, for my aunt, my cousins. I would like to say to you, stay together. Hold on to Jesus. Family is everything. And we all are here. We are representing our families. And I would like to caution us all. Let's forget about the things behind us. Let's forget about yesterday. And let's look about today. today, what is before us, what is in front of us. And I would like to encourage us all, if you don't know Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, today's the day. Accept Him. Paul said, I press towards the mark to win the prize of the high calling of Christ Jesus. What are you pressing towards today? People are pressing towards financial security, material things, but at the end of the day, it doesn't matter. What matters is life after death. Where are we going to spend eternity? Some of us are fighting over things that aren't worth fighting over. But let us hold each other's hand. And let us, you know, last week, or I think it's the week before, I saw somebody carve out a puncture, and the police, they lend assistance. It's such a beautiful thing to see. They're going along the road, when they saw, they stopped to help the young lady. And sometimes we see our brothers and sisters falling by the way. And instead of us going to help, we talk about it. Sometimes we help, we go and tell the neighbor, tell somebody else what we would have done for that person. Now is not time for that. Let us hold each other's hand, because we can't do it on our own. We need each other. So, and I'm quite certain, if my uncle was alive and well and kicking, as we would say, that is what he would have encouraged us to do. Let us hold each other's hand and let us move forward. And let us keep pressing. And you can ask yourself, I'm going to ask myself, what am I pressing towards? What is it? What is the prize that I'm trying to get? So today, my encouragement to all of you, and I love my uncle, I love my family. Each and every one of my family, I love them. I am not here, I'm in Georgetown, and I haven't seen my uncle for a long time. But I remember the times when he was there. And when I heard of his death, I said, I don't care. Rain or snow, I have to come, and I have to pay tribute to my uncle, because I know what he would have done for me. So today, let us remember the good things. Let us forget about the bad things. Because when we hold grudge and we hold things in our hearts, it makes us sick. We cannot live a healthy life when we're carrying things. So today, my encouragement is let's hold each other's hand and let's go forward. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. The fondest memory that I have of Uncle Roy, and I echo the sentiments of my cousin Odessa. He would always greet you as my niece, every time he sees you. But one of the fondest memories that I have of him is that every time he comes to Georgetown to visit my mom from there, he would call ahead and promise that he's going to be coming. And we need to have a basin, and we need to have a mug of slime. Always, Uncle Lloyd never ate at our home in a plate, he ate in a basin. And that basin had to be filled with food, and the cup of swan had to have low nights. I remember that distinctly. I remember he had his camera, and he would always say to my sisters and I, y'all food, I'm going to take pictures. And he would take those pictures, I have pictures until this day, of which he took of us. I remember also, came down one time when he was in the country and came, picked us up. It was my cousin, Kayan. I can't remember if his name was here. But we all have those pictures that he took of us on the bridge. He packed all of us up in the car and took us to that Benny Hinn concert. We couldn't see Benny Hinn, but we were there. And, you know, those are the memories that I would want to keep with me. That's how I would want to remember my uncle when I came to see him. I said, okay, remember me? And he looked at me, but when I said, oh, well, no, he shaved his head. So I knew that he remembered me. So I just want to bring condolences from his sister in New York, Auntie Lynette, and his niece as well, his brother, Uncle Danny. We bring our condolences to the immediate family. We want to let you know that you're in our prayers, and everyone that is here, we want to thank you for coming out and supporting. And as our dear sister said, we're here to celebrate his life, and that's how he's going to go out to be today. We're in celebration. So thank you so much.
became such a close friend. I would say, I wonder how that would feel. I said, I won't cry. I won't feel no way. Because you know the life that we used to live, right? It wasn't something easy. Right? But it turned out that he was my father. Right? No matter what he did, he was still my father. And when he returned, it was kind of a hard thing to accept. I tell you from the bottom of my heart, it was very hard. I was frustrated. I was angry, bitter. Very bitter. That I didn't want anything for him. Right? But I thank God for a mother. She stand up. It was hard for her to forgive and to move on. When somebody doing something, all you need to do is to forgive you. Let God direct you. Let God tell you when to do it. Right? You care. You also want forgiveness. And he... It was so hard. So hard for my mother too. When he got bedridden, that was another matter. Because he had to be with everything for him. But I want to thank God for the strong woman he has placed in her life. She went on, she cried, she weep, she wrong. Right? But God kept her to do this. I know it was for a reason. Right? That we must learn to forgive, forget, and move on. No matter what the man will do you, no matter what your husband will do you, forgiveness is the greatest part of any relationship. If you want to go to heaven, you have to forgive man who you see here. If you cannot forgive man who you see here, nobody is perfect. Right? We may make all kinds of mistakes, but I thank God that my father was able to accept Christ. You know, sometimes you just studying why men can't come to the senses right away. You know, it's a woman will catch yourself and put yourself back in order. Get the right up and running. Right? I mean, why the men cannot do the same? Some of them. Right? But God is able. Right? God is able. He is married to the backslider. Right? He said, a righteous man fallen. How much time? One time? No. Right? And I want to thank God for strengthening my mom. She loved him. She feed him. Susan reached to the door, George. Yeah, but you're what? You're hungry? Yes. Yes, I'm hungry. Right, that's when he was talking. You know, when he was going down, I watched him, I said, oh my God, my pap, you really got patient. You have stomach, right, to do what you're doing. Right, you have to have patience. It's like a whole other baby. It's like I said, once a man, twice a child. Right, he come as a child again. He couldn't do nothing for himself, clean himself, feed himself, nothing. I can't go for my children, them do more than me. Tell you, and it's true. They did more than me. I got time for lying. Right? They're done with that. They did more than me. They help.
That's true.
Feed. Yes. I get the dog to be like, cheer, give me water. Oh, the one minute she will give me water. I don't think he died thirsty. She loves the water bottle to his mouth. Right? But you know, sometimes you still give his water to Joe. You used to have me laughing. Right? Something like that, you won't think he got some big words in the mouth, little words, all kind of words. Right? And my children are like nonsense. If you hear on this children, mommy, if you hear on grandfather say.
And anyway, it was not nice. You don't wish death on anyone. You don't wish sickness on anyone. Right? You just pray that they will live. Even though it was punishing, I said, God, it's best to go. Something about her womb, and he said, your body eating, eat talking. I said, well, the roll is all up your body. He said, shut up. She will call you and text me, Niglin, this money won't eat. This money could be going. I said, hey, the time you reach here. When the time reach, he will go. But God was waiting on my mother to say that. You know, eventually she got tired. You know, she's not young and poor too. Jumping around, doing this and doing that for him, rolling over me. And most of all, we are thankful We are very thankful to our aunts, right? Who used to support him, our aunt near and far, and our cousin. We used to support him, right? Financially. Who will send pampers, who will send this, who will send that. We are very thankful. Even those who made this here possible, right? We want to say thank you with a grateful heart. Right? And God say, even though this has come, he say, in everything, give thanks. Right? He said, when it's a blessing to die in Christ. Right? Because you know when you die, you know where you're going. Right? So it's a blessing to die in Christ. So each and every one of you, if you don't know the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, my cousin said, give your heart today. Because like he said, too late shall be the cry of many. Right? So let us be the too late. Let us be there when we can keep drinking our milk and our honey. Right? And we've been walking on the street of boy, you wear gold of men, you can get all of them. Down to take words. Thank you.
Celebrating the life. Yes. Amen. From the living God. Is anyone else coming to the
room? I said God is good. He is absolutely good. He said everything we must give down. I do not see God, but life is alive. He said all the souls are mine. He said all the souls are mine. And this afternoon, I'm the supervisor of Nicolette. I am privileged to be here among you, and I just want to give my condolences to you. I want you to know God is with you. He said, call upon him, and he will hear, and he will answer, and he will show you great and mighty things that you know not of. And this afternoon, I just want to tell you, hold on to God. Hold on to him, and you're going to see what he can do, and you're going to see what he will do. I'm a blessed.
From you getting your thoughts together, and then we probably just after then you have a tour. People, I believe maybe somebody have to go back to talk today.
Yes. Yeah.
Right. So we watch the timing here, right?
Hallelujah.
God indeed made a way. And it's so wonderful. I'm preambling for a very, very important person. Persons who are on their way. In the meantime, just sing with me. I don't know how far I'm going to get.
Hallelujah. You have won the victory. You are the reason I'm here.
and we don't know, but God knows.
So when we talk, he wants been there and done that. He went there for God. He was second in command to the pastor then, as our pastor here said. He used to be alive. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. You know, Pastor,
I remember the good old days. You forgot one. But I remember that big drake. I told my husband about him. And the drake was stolen. And the drake was stolen on a Christmas Eve. Because we can lie a little bit in the freezer for Christmas Day. And you know we Baptists. And we families. You know the boxing, they come, hurry.
Yes.
My brothers, they roam for that. We roam for that tree because in the yard here we had a big pond and we only had lots of stocks, turkey and everything else. They roam and they found that cup. And they took that cup away. We had a lovely send off on that boxing. That kind of a year it was. That was very small. Yeah. I remember we had a lot of dogs. And Lloyd had a dog that he used to run with him till to the airport when he's driving and back. And I remember if a dog dies, we had that announcement. We call it Jones' dog. And all the other dogs in the yard, in the street, by name and so, and they used to build a box, a square box, and they would put a rope, and they had our dogs tied on to that box. I don't know if Pastor can remember that. And they would pull the dogs, and the dog pulling their dog, and they would say, boots, boots, so the dog would bark, wow, 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 and take it that dog, wherever that burial place. Those were the good times. Those were the wonderful times. I remember with my brothers, they were six, and my sister, the two of us, we were here in Guyana, in Barca. And the other two, the other one, she was with my grandmother, and she was living in Suriname. She married Dutch, and she was afterwards went on to Holland and she died here. So she had that joy, you know, of sliding down the hill here. When we opened up another branch, we just had to go there. The water is so powerful. And when we went there, man, the water used to push us down. And before it was all of this, we had a nice big pool. So the water used to push us down. And let me tell you, as you know, we moved to Winston crutches. He's at Vera Brown.
He used to be in it too.
And we all gone in that place and we swim up all around here. I remember my dad is not a partition and he couldn't catch us. People crutches would sail down with his crutch. And then we swim in and I'd come to that landing, whichever landing, we swim to the other one. White, white, white after swimming for the whole day. And we ran home because daddy couldn't swim. But we had fun. For those who can remember us. And even moving around, I was telling, I was showing Podesta and Vanessa, my nieces, where the mom was living. And then my brother used to crawl in there. Uh-huh. Don't laugh at that, we do. But we could go on and go on. But today, I want to read Eulogy for the Life of the Late Lloyd Michael George, also known as George. Lloyd Michael George was born on September 3rd, 1950. Leon and Hyacinth George, deceased. He attended St. Anthony's Roman Catholic School, where he gained his education, and he also attended the church there. He was an altar boy. serving God. And there is where we have gotten all our sin names in those days. That's religion. Yeah.
He worked at Coe Island as a very young apprentice and completed
his work here with Mr. John Williams. Thank God for remembering the name.
He left there and he went on to work later with Nagasar Sawmilling Company
as a saw doctor many years ago. You know what that means? If noise is not there, the sound cannot go on. He has to make those saws work in together with him. That's one kind of story.
He married to Pamela Stevens in 1972. And that union bore one child,
Nicholas George, and his wife here. Stan Nicholas. He's so perfect. That is George, his eldest and first child. But you don't know it. You never know. You know today. Thank you, my lady, for answering to your aunt to be here despite what you are going through. Anyhow, that union did not last for long.
He later married Pamela Jones in 1989.
And that union bore 5 children. Donnie George, deceased, with a badly elder sister. Lloyd Jr. George, because of unforeseen circumstances, he's not here today. Also known as Junior.
Fian George Marshall.
He's right here. Fian, you know he's here.
Nicolene George Fraser.
And Kevin George, known as Debbie. I don't know if they can remember you, Debbie. He's a Dara Safari Selassie.
You see, you're not a threat, huh?
Whatever he is, God understands.
On the side,
you know, you normally buy your lunches in here. What do you want on the side?
On the side, Lydia,
another Lloyd, how powerful he is, but Hannah.
And others who are still there
to be identified. Hallelujah, praise the Lord, we celebrate his life. He was macho. And I said, Lloyd
was the third child of 9
from my parents.
But he performed the duty as though he was the first.
We call him in our home, Mama. He was Mama JP for us.
Because I remember vividly, Lloyd taught me
to plant my hair using my old doll.
He was the cook
when Mom was sick.
He was the disciplinarian.
We had to get up.
That's who they are. They have to sweep it clean. Sometimes it hurts my heart.
When I come now, I see leaves and so there. He would beat us, he would club us to do our work. And the thing is that I'm noticing some of the younger children now, they don't live up to have that respect for the older ones. But we have to respect him with some lashes that even accompany back.
So, he provided for his family.
He was hardworking. He was burning coal, doing all the other things, you know, driving car, blah, 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 all kinds of things. He got thirsty, right?
Yes.
He was a little thirsty. I remember my husband gave him a car too, PBD 5570, and he ran it and parked it in the bush, and he's finished with it. Yeah, those are the good old days.
In his later days, he made some mistakes, some terrible ones. We all know it. You can guess what was bad. Of which we didn't know why. We couldn't understand. Many days we prayed. Many days we wondered what was happening, if it was going out of his mind. But the Lord, he knew this.
Okay. Lord, we have to do it the other way. For the first communion, had 11 grandchildren. 8 girls and 3 boys came out of Nicholas, of whom you don't know, but he's right here in Barbica. And Jamal, Constable Jamal George, is Lloyd George's grandson. That's my name. I pray, I want you to know God is powerful. He's bigger than the universe. I knew my brother had to be here one day. And I said, Lord, connect us with Nicholas. And then I learned that I got connected with Nicholas kind of history. Lloyd didn't get to know 11 grandchildren. 2 girls are studying in the department with us. Another policeman is in Region 9. So the Georges may not. My brother's crying all 3 counties of Guyana. Escribo, Demerara, and Bubis. We even dominated a little bit in Suriname because the whole bus was coming down here because my eldest is married Dutch, but they will reach very late. So it's going to be on YouTube. You are always going to be able to get to see those who are also my sisters right here via live streaming. My brother Danny, that you know, is Bonds. He's also live streaming. His pressure went up. And he works at a hospital in the USA. And he's just waiting to get up into the wall. The body is good. He didn't have to go there. Then the other faction of his life, or Tyrese, that sang earlier. Denise. Daniel. But he's not going to be like the Daniel in the Lion's Den. Delight and Venicia. We also have, remember I talked about from this side, we have Empress. And we have a big Joshua, I'm getting it right, trying to get it right. We also have, from the Marshall's clan, Gerald, Jeremiah, and Josiah. And we still have those yet to come, you recognize. Today, I want to thank God who He is. He's going to always remain God, all by Himself. I want to thank Him for softening the heart of my sister now. I want to thank Him for orchestrating the whole performance that she portrayed. I want to thank Him for allowing her to be obedient and to do what He wanted her to do, and not what she wanted to do. So, Mary Jones George, thank you for hearing my prayer. You've done great, and it's only God could have given you that strength. I told her I know when my brother used to do
kids to her. I tell her I know when she used to be among us in that same house. I will tell you how.
Some we have to talk and some of them have to talk. Hallelujah, praise the Lord.
I want to thank God for my nieces, my nephews, my great nieces, the little ones. I want to thank God for all of you coming out to remember. It's a very, very hard thing sometimes people don't remember the good things. And it shows up now in this pandemic that all dwell on what's bad happening. But you go back home and lie down or sit down and relax, reminisce. There are so many good things that are coming out in this season. That we must love each other. We must fear for each other. We must be there for each other. We must not despise any other. And you know what the Lord said? In 2 Chronicles 14:7, he said, my people, who are called by my name, not even, not my name of possibilities, but who called by God, should humble themselves and pray and seek his face and walk away. Walk away from your wicked ways. Then you will hear from heaven. We want to hear from heaven in this pandemic. And then he shall heal the land. Take that and put it over your, get it into your thoughts, because you think from your thoughts, and just work it. Work the word of God, because it works. I want to thank the friends who are here from Vidarabu. Is Robert around? Robert Anderson, is he around? I remember the good old days at the desk, Robert. And my brother used to take us out. I came up with six brothers. He was the only brother who used to take us out. You know, Leon, Yalom, God rest him there. He said, I ain't no watch man. I'm not taking you anyway. But no one had a fear in heart. And many other persons in heart, but I guess for that. I want to thank those from the Nagasar group, the Brawars, Mr. Leonard, Jewel German, is she here? She used to cook for him and all of that. Miss Valley Johnston. And so many others who I might not be able to remember your names to me. As I did say, I want to thank all of you. I remember the caring that some of you would have done today. I want to say thank you. Sometimes I would come to Mark, but I never get a chance to really intermingle and to continue. Because of my chores that I have to do. Lloyd Eftemore is not. Pamela knows joy. His children. You heard about them. His grandchildren, you heard about them. His brothers, Winston, crutches to be able to. He's in the very wrong meeting there, he said. Orin Victor, Dunsford, Anthony, yeah, all our speakers. And he's unable to be here today because he lives in the USA. His sisters, Lynette, she is on live streaming. She's also in the USA. And they were unable to come, but they supported tremendously. And I want to thank him openly for doing that. We are on the servant. I want to thank his neighbors. Also say that he left more his nieces, you heard of them. His great nieces, I think we have one here from Fibo, you know Fibo Ronald, his daughter is here.
daughter's mother is here as well. His nephews and his great nephew. His friends. Relatives. Maybe those who come into contact with him. Those that are hurting. Those who would have gotten 3 drops. Those who would have gotten a smile.
Yeah. His wife said to me that once she was in a car with
him and he was picking up someone. He took out his coffee and he had his prayer. And she said, why you got to do that? She said, when she got in there, she got to bed, she got to know that the smell is nice. That's the kind of love that carried in his heart. Lloyd, Michael George, we will all miss you, my brother. Rest in peace. Rest in perfect peace. Rise in glory. Thank you very much. Jamal, you still want to sing? I think Jamal is going to sing a song.
Salam. I like to bless your heart, sing a song about me. I was going to do it earlier, but as you can see, I had to work.
Hard to play. Sometimes hard to stay grateful. Oh, it's painful. Hurts so bad. Sometimes it's hard to breathe. It's hard to keep. Oh. We keep holding on to what could have been. It's been goodbye. It's still alive. In the morning, it's gonna be alright. Circumstances, it's in the past. Even if we don't fully understand why that didn't happen to the good people.
So much pain. It's a blessing. Sometimes the rain. It's still a blessing. You never see the silver lining in a flower with the silver dollar. You never know how much truly happened until you go without it. When day is going to turn to another season, you're going to see that all your tragedy you have is for another reason. It's just a temporary goodbye. So we got to keep our heads high. The rain's coming down and it's pouring. The joy is going to come in the morning.
So goodbye, to see the light. In the morning, it's going to be alright. Circumstances, it's in the past. Even if we don't fully understand why that things happen to the good people.
Thank you.
Realizing that some have to be leaving to the city. In a world filled with hostility, that we can find out. Some people today are falling in love, while some seem to be falling out of love. I'm here in this room by the visit. For a long time now, I have fallen out with love, not with my wife, not with the children. But I've fallen out of love with my voice. So, because I've fallen out of love with my voice, amen, I will not be on the Lord, because some people are in love with your voice. It's God. And I want to be extremely loud. So I've fallen out of my voice. Amen. I'm not accustomed to this. I've fallen out of love with this. I'm going to box it when we shut up. Because I'm falling out of love with my voice. So I don't want to heal myself all the time. I need you one more time to refresh you today. That in circumstances like these, it only presents opportunity for the church of the living God, where we can draw strength from each other. It's not a place where we come just to mourn and feel that God is the king. We serve a caring God. We serve a God, oh my God, yes, God. In life, so many things. In life, so many things are circumstantial. But I'm here to allow us to understand, to refresh us today, that we serve a God who is beyond all circumstances, and that He is God all by Himself. What makes Him God? Because He is Creator and Sustainer. I love what the psalmist says. I will, and was an early on, we do not serve a circumstantial God, but we serve a God who is above all circumstances. That is why the psalmist says, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continue be in my mouth. Well, hallelujah. He said, my God, and His praise shall continue in my mouth. My soul, he said, shall make a boast to the Lord. Do I have a witness here today that in spite of the devil's seed to be masquerading and possessing himself, that you know that your God lives and that you shall stand at the latter day? Father, and our God, today we come before you, acknowledging our frailties, God. But you are the all-powerful one. So we look to you today to draw strength like no other. It's not hard. Oh, God, it's not easy losing a loved one. But we pray today, you promise to be the lifter of our heads. And certainly today, you're the lifter of the Williams head. You're the lifter, oh God, of the churches and all the other families and lost, my God. So I pray today a special strength to pull through what they're going through. Let your peace continue to be their portion, God. As we look to you today, in a particular way, we thank you for the wife, Lord God. Oh God, in a time where there are so many nights, we are thankful for wives. And understand their responsibility. What they took before man and God, for richer or poorer, for better or worse, until death do they depart. So have your way today. As we call upon your name, let your word come alive in the hearts of some people today, as we will give you the glory at the end. It's not a little fun, right? I said just now, we have too many lives, but we need wives. Amen. A man can't stand. A man can't stand a man all the time, all the time. But a man needs a wife. And here we today, somebody. We in a funeral service, right? What do you say? You said, and I have to go over here, we will celebrate it. The life. Amen. So, in times like these, even as again, you're not here just, you know, to be moved today. I'm here to somehow, by the grace of God, to lift your spirit today in understanding that in the world in which we live, where so many things are falling to pieces, you cannot allow your relationship with God to fall to pieces. Because, come on now, He met you and He brought you out along with it. And tattered, my God, but God put the pieces together. That's why we earn the right, hallelujah, to give God a shout. The Bible says, let everything that has breath praise His name. So we are here today to praise Him. We are here to let the devil know, in spite of the circumstances.
God. The church has gone radical because there's some who are mammonizing themselves. There are some all that know is religion, but I'm here to tell you today that relationship is far above and beyond religion. Some of them, they are distant from us and trying to tell us that we serve in the same God. No, sir! No, man! Oh, my God, the church is on a different plane. The church first has been blood-bought. The church has first been blood-bought and then blood-washed. So how can you tell me that we all the same when you don't have a relationship with him? And stand by it. We don't serve the same God. The church of the living God serves the God of Abraham, Isaac, and of Jacob. When we say Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, it means a covenant-keeping God. That's the God we serve. And we don't play church. We do church. Because we understand opposition. I said to you, not supposed to love the performance. So let me stick to what I said. Just to engage our interest today, I just want to read a few verses from Job. And then I'm going to respond a bit. Then, because after they say some things preachers need to understand, keep behind the head. Two things importantly. First, you need to get up. Three things. You need to get up. Preachers are talking about, and those who contemplating becoming preachers. You need to get up. You need to speak up, and then you need to shut up.
Yes.
So I get up already, I'm going to speak up, and then I'm going to shut up. Just now. In the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. We have in church. Hey. Thank you, Jesus. In the book of Job. In the 19th chapter. Recorded in the book of Job. From the 25th verse through the 27th. Again, the little preacher, I forgot my church congregation. I forgot my space at home. I can't read. I gotta trust the Lord. Amen. That's just mandate. I'm trusting the Lord here today. Amen. It says, and this testimony. For I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. And thereafter my skin worms destroyed his body, yet in my flesh shall I see God, whom I shall see for myself, and my eyes shall behold, and not another. Though my reins be consumed within me. Hallelujah. What a testimony. In serving God, every man, every woman needs to have a testimony. Your testimony is where God brought you from, to where you at, and where he's about to take you. Some slogan, I'm certain many of us, we intelligent, we wise enough, God read this slogan, you'll see my glory. But ask me about my story. Some of you don't want to talk this story, because it's so diverse and nasty, but I tell you something, oh, greater the problem, greater the situation, God is able. All you got to do is call upon the name. I'm not saying
in the name of Jesus. There is deliverance in the name of Jesus. Oh, thank God for deliverance. But I bless him for restoration. Hallelujah. To prophesy to somebody here today that the latter is going to exceed your former. Hallelujah. That God is about to bring you over. That God's going to allow you to shine never before, because come and understand that he who has begun a good work in you, he's able to complete it.
Amen.
To the church of the living God is not seeking under the given circumstances to run for shelter or to cover. We fight it back. Hallelujah. That is why Job, this man of God, hallelujah, hear me today. What we don't need as a church is more critics.
Amen.
What we don't need is negative minds around us. We need an invasion of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. We need God more than ever. In a world that is hostile and becoming much more hostile, we've got to set our force of God, because he is our sure foundation. Job, this man that feared God, and hear me today, I've gone past, I guess you're streaming live, I've gone past, I don't want people to be calling me man of God. God-fearing person. Hallelujah. The Bible says the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. God, if you fear God, some of us will love to be ugly and dumb things that you do. Because that reverence is not the many of them that have come man of God. And the man of God will be so wicked sometimes. So we want to be categorized as no man of God. A God-fearing man. I fear the Lord. That's why I preach the way I do. And in this timeline, there are so many that are willing to compromise. I'm not going along to get along with nobody. I stand my ground and I do what God has called me to do. Oh my God, hey, you see the door we have in the church today. But that's the thing. I'm not so long ago. I'm not going to get on the face of anyone. But what has happened over time, that people want to compromise the word of God. The one to go along to get along. And in this going along to get along business, many are being lost. Because righteousness still exalts a nation. And sin is a reproach to any person. We got to understand that what God's looking for, right, oh my God. I didn't say righteousness. I said righteousness. God is looking for. Hallelujah. So in Job's scenario, it says the sons of men, the sons of God, came to present themselves before God. And when God looked up in the earth, he saw a man that resembled him. He saw a man that took on his image and made boast in that man. He said, consider my servant Job, a man that is just, a man that is upright. That is why the Bible says, what shall it profit a man, a woman, to gain a thorn of one thorn of thorn out of you? And his soul is in danger. It profits nothing. So here, the devil, he picked a wrong fight, thought that Job was materialistic, that all he thought to himself, that Job was just living for the material things. So God said, hey, skip this, get him as you do. I'm going to allow you certain leverage. You can touch the man, do whatever you want, but don't kill that man. Hear me today, somebody. The devil has power, but limited power. We serve an all-powerful God, hallelujah. He is not limited, he is not restricted, but he is all-powerful, hallelujah. That's why we deem him as the Lion of the Tribe of Judah, he is the conquering lion.
came out on top. That today, he is our high priest. He is our mediator.
So the devil, move vehemently against you and afflicted the man. So much so that the closest person to him, the better half, he would say. The same thoughts of the devil not being projected to her.
Why you do more responding than that? When the man get radically, the man became very much angry, righteously indignant. Said, the talk of one who fools you. The incarnate of you, said, like one of them. Let go of them. Like that, you know, when you don't want to get yourself too much in a fix, you say that mindset. So you're not going to go past that pastor, said that mindset. So in the midst of it all, God said, hey! The man said, the talk of you. When the man received bread at the hand of God, you know what that means? He said, look, the Lord gave and the Lord take. I'm saying, I said already on, we do not serve a circumstantial God, but we serve a God above circumstantial. Then you can find a praise in the midst of the storm, in the midst of the flood. You can find a praise that still says, it is well. It is well with my soul. I may suffer loss. I may suffer material, the loss of material things, but I have the God on the inside of me. Who lives? And when that was said, we don't talk religion. We talk relationship. We don't talk wayward children. I know. Rastaman said, Rastaman don't think so. Rastaman knows. And if Rastaman knows so, I know that I know that I know. Because Rastaman don't know. So I know that I know that I know that there is a God. I know. That my Redeemer lived. Hallelujah. In spite of the flood, in spite of the storm, in spite of what the hell was brought against it, he had the confidence based on a relationship that he would have fostered with God over the years. That when the time and when hell would have broken loose against him, could have placed his hands on what exactly was happening to him, had some friends, and instead of them come, it got to be at the sin, at the first. When you're going through a little struggle in the church, we have so many judges. We even have better than Judge Julie and Judge Mathis. We got so many judges. It got to be at the sin, brother. And your sin catching up with you. Your sin, sister. Repent, sister. This time you think, you know you're going through places. Because in order for you to come through, it got to go through. This thing is not no fly by night or nothing. You gotta walk with God. You gotta know God. You gotta have this relationship. That is why Job said, yes, Lord. Yes. And then I find that one with that. Then Job said, for I know that my Redeemer lives. And after my skin burn destroyed his body, yet shall I see. Even in the Old Testament scripture. Here we have people who had the form of short knowing, understanding about the death, the burial, and the resurrection of Jesus. That's why the church is in a class all by itself. Because in those religious organizations, in those religious entities, they do not talk about the death burial. Yes, they talk about the death, they talk about the burial, but it's stopping halfway. This thing is not halfway. Yes, Lord. So that is why when you step down the aisle, yes, Lord, and I want to know who will be that living person. When you step down the aisle, and then the man before you were sensitized, as far as taking the vow, the man had to tell you, you know what? Nowadays, we need our modern times. And you don't have to take that old kind of vow. Hey, what vow are we going to take? For Richard? Not for poor. For better, never for worse. But the man got a plan. Because in times like these, when Brother Lloyd Michael would have fallen ill, the wife would have said, I said, for better, not for worse. I am up. That's the vow I took
you gotta watch these men nowadays. Don't let the tech smart you. You're taking the whole fall. Because in sickness and in health, until death, we got part. So you've got to fulfill your vow. Come on now. Might have been a twist of fate, but the word of God cannot be twisted. You've got to toe the line. You've got to understand that He who called you, He's able to keep you, Almighty. He's able to keep you, and as He would have kept you, He would strategically position you. So Job confessed it. I know. Rastaman said that he know. But Job gone past Rastaman. Job, I know that my Redeemer lives. And that He shall stand at the last day. I know after my sin. This one house there reminds someone here today. We can beautify that. I love the ladies. I'm not a religious man, but I love the ladies. How they fix his head. They'll fix the face, yes Lord. They'll fix the legs. So I've been so long that you want to know what kind of work you can do in the house. Bless the Lord, Lord. Bless the Lord. You're stepping out and stepping over. You know, you have your hard days. So thank God that if you're blessed enough and you're doing well. And you're not smelling hair. You do well. So you have a little servant. They don't know this respect. So that you can take good care of those days in the name of the Lord. But understand that when push comes to shove, you gotta do your wifely duties. You gotta forget the honor and fascinating. You gotta say what you give for no for him, and you give him more. So do the man. Fix the man food. And Jesus. So this is not time to be backstabbing. This is not time to be backbiting. This is time to be pushing the gospel charity on. You've got to know that you know that God has called you, and this is for a long haul. Amen. So Job said, I know, because I have. He had a relationship with God. And despite the circumstances, he was able to trust God. The Bible says, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not unto your own understanding. He said, in all your ways, acknowledge Him and He shall direct your path. I want to conclude this afternoon and say to somebody here today that God is your strength. He is my strength. He is our strength. And tell somebody that I say, don't tell them I say. Use my name. Pastor or apostle, whatever, him. Title don't get to my head there, remind someone. And if you don't say Apostle Jones or Pastor Jones, Brother Jones, anyone will do. My name is Linda Marshall Jones. So anyone, Brother Gord, that will do. That ear. Somebody in the ear. If you come apostle, I hear you again. What about the face? Stiff like starch. And then we know we have to be given that title. Because you ask them where they went. When some of them were sent to school, they went on to the school. God is a good God, church. Understand that He had to say, yeah, we might trust Him. We can trust Him in our entire lives. And what I'm discovering in conclusion this afternoon, that this life of living here on earth cannot be compared. This life that we live here on earth cannot be compared with the life hereafter. I say to someone here today that there is hope beyond the grave. There is hope beyond the grave. Amen. It doesn't stop here. That's why. And right now, just on the back of the list, and the name on the phone person is gone. The name on the list. But hear me today. I don't want your name to be on any list. It must first be on the list of heaven. We have a secure list. The list won't get mixed up. And the name won't disappear out the list. Your name has got to be enlisted and enrolled in the Lamb's book of life. That when the word is called up yonder, you can say present. Oh my God, God's list supersedes and sees any other man-made earthly list. Because God is God, and tell you who has the final say. It is God who has the final say. Can I get the amen today? Because God is God and will forever be God. Oh, Jesus.
be encouraged that this life here will not be able to compete with that over there. So they say something to us this afternoon. Here on earth is preparation for over there. You don't get to the big stage with your voice not so nice like mine and say you're doing something. You practice. Because you know all your hands have been a great cloud. And you want to hear that. Then you thought that I was never part of that. You don't want to hear me. You practice and you practice till you get it right. Amen. So now here is rehearsal stage. We're over there where it is perfected. May God help us today. Be encouraged. We're not here to build on anyone. As I said, what we don't need is more than criticism. What we don't need is someone, you know, the dogs are good with you. Shut them up. You don't know you're that someone's doing. Shut them up. It's everybody I have, of course, they're not 100% bad, that I'm good. And Mr. Jordan is a good man. Amen. He was a good man. Good man so much so that he needed our children. He was blessed. He did not try to stop the multiplication plan of God. He executed the multiplication plan to be fruitful. In God's view, there's nothing like a bastard. In God's view, there's nothing like a bastard. Because when God allows, He allows. And if you talk to a bastard, then I want to get too good. If you talk to a bastard, what about Joseph? My name is Jesus. Setting the example. And in the hall of fame, instead of us all talking about, but bring this up. In the hall of fame, we would have done right. We would have written her off. The one we have. She's so stinking good. But she did a good turn. And because she did a good turn, she was able to be mentioned in the hall of fame. Because she hit the spot. And she had accomplished the will and purpose of God. She did her part. And she made a contract. One thing she says, "Oh, no, you when you come, there's going to be the sign. And don't forget my father's house." She didn't only receive for herself. She said, "Don't forget my daddy's house. And I got my body and my sister's too." So the men said, "Bring them all in the house." So the men, we come in and begin to take possession of the land. We get a pass. Your Father, we bless you. We honor you today. We are thankful for another opportunity. May your word be preached. May your word be dispensed, God. But I pray, God, that your word will die and germinate and be full fruit, oh God, in the season. Let your peace remain. What I want to do, all the family in every kind of son, all the family in every immediate relative. Father and our God, in times like these, certainly we need you. You are our present help in times of trouble. And today, yes, these are troublous times, Lord God. It's not easy at no time, my God, losing the loss of a loved one. So we ask today that you will strengthen them, Lord. That you will be their continued shield and buckler, God. That you protect them from the wiles of the enemy. Every critical word that will be assigned over their lives, every word curse that they've been pronounced in time past over the charge's life is not being revoked, is not being reversed, is not being condemned. And I pray, God, that this will be as a situation, Lord God, helping them to move from strength to strength, more united than ever, because God, you are in charge. Bless every family member today, and even friends who come to pay their final respect. We give you praise today, and we give you glory in no other name but Jesus. I hope I stopped for my word. I said I'm not something about my voice. You can have a seat, but let me allow the door to walk. You have amazing grace. What we can do, I'm not going to be here. Thank you so much, and watch me go. I've got to make sure to put my own pocket in the car and come. So what's possible? You know, some pastors is dumb from the plate. Some pastors pastors. Some pastors dumb. Not dumb, but too dumb from the pit. Because the hand tight. They're nothing because the hand too tight. But I love the pit. It has been a part of my life, even before I was saved. So watch what I put in. I didn't put it up on the back of thing because, you know, if the church is pastor and you give, and you can take it up back and pray it when they put it down. No! I ain't taking it up back. I'm leaving it. You got to put it to give it. You're going to give it to the Lord. Amen. You see, you have amazing grace. You have amazing grace. So just after the song, and we take the offering, we thank God for time, then we're going to have the sister come and close in prayer, and then they have the view of the body. Am I right? So please give this afternoon. Amen. They want to build their project. You'll give it to the family, George's family. That'll be enough. So you'll give it to them. You give it to the cause of the church.
I'm tight, you can't get nothing. If your hand tight, you can't get nothing. If your hand tight, you can't get nothing. When it brings to belief, I saw the Lord.
We come against every devouring spirit that over time have been devouring some of them, their finances, because they were never taught to give out of lack. So we pray today that those who have given out of God, even their little that they had, Lord, you'll multiply their seeds sown and allow harvest of hearts. Allow their health, somebody's health today. Hey, Shaka, I speak wellness for someone's life today. That your seed soul and may go far away into heaven in the completion of the building. I bless you today. It is that I must increase at this time.
Yeah. And I pray a final prayer. And it's for my screening. I want to acknowledge my husband, who a lot of persons never really get to meet, and so since I got married, 37 years ago. Please stand, Cousin. And Lloyd was his favorite brother-in-law. I want to acknowledge the presence of my sister-in-law, Sister Jackie, in prayer. I want to say thanks, a special man. It's very special. So, Sister Jackie, and I want to say that God sees his brother-in-law to more and his sister-in-law. Thanks once again. Thanks for coming. Good morning,
everyone. Shall we all go up there?
Correct.
Part of our doing great prayers and practices are going to be going on. You are, Lord God, you are God. Lord God, I thank you, Lord God, for your presence, Lord. Oh Lord God, I give up, God. I put a blood, Lord Jesus, in the atmosphere right now, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God, for bringing everyone at this point here, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God, for this day, Lord Jesus. For this is the day that the Lord has made. Oh God, we're going to rejoice and be glad in it, Lord God. We're not going to mourn, Lord God, but we are going to rejoice in your presence this afternoon, Lord God. Oh God, I put a blood edge in every person that is bowing. In your presence, Lord God, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, thank you for bringing them here safe today, Lord Jesus. And Lord God, as they leave, Lord God, we want to restore their respect to the home, Lord Jesus. I put a blood in the area. I put a blood in the road. I put a blood in the water. I put a blood in the atmosphere. I put a blood in the
this time, as I said again, let's get a little fast. You can get a healing done. Then we have to go up the hill. So some family members, and then you have to be leaving, but we were here to make sure that we take care of the lady. So kindly at this time, open up for the viewing.
Streets of gold. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory.
Neighbor, Palm and a whole set of them. You see all these people around here, Dunberry. Look, Palm, there in the
front. Oh,
you go. Go outside and see your face.
Can I come in the camera?
Huh?
Tell him on the front side, that's the front line now.
Yeah.
Are we ready now?
Yes, go ahead.
Yes.
For as much as it please Almighty God to take out of the world Lloyd Michael George, we therefore, stand by with somebody with something, stand with little mark. We therefore commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, looking for the resurrection and the life of the world to come through our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose coming, at whose second coming,
you hear it?
The corruptible bodies of those who sleep in him shall be changed and shall be made like unto his glorious body, according to the mighty working whereby he is able to subdue all things unto him. Father and our God, this afternoon we look to you, who you are our present help and time of trouble. Even as we lay to rest Lloyd Michael George, looking forward, Lord God, for the resurrection and life to come through your Son, Jesus' name. I pray for the loved ones. I pray for the relatives, friends, neighbors, Father, that you continue to lift our hearts and lift our spirits. We come up against any further attack or assault upon this family. We intercept and we bisect the plans of the devil, and we apply the blood to our lives, where the devil cannot find us, much more to locate us. Let your peace reign supreme as we give you the glory. We give you the honor today. We say thanks for the life lived for the late Lloyd Michael George. And let your peace, oh God, be his portion. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Hallelujah. We can further
control down.
Yeah. Hallelujah. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust.
Anna, show. Show it in there. Daniel,
enjoy. Daniel, enjoy. Daniel, enjoy.
Daniel, Reza, throw. Roches will throw for you. Throw.
Thank you. So you're going back to see them?
Huh?
You're going back?
Yes, I got a boat. I'll catch a boat. If I don't catch a boat.
That's your journey.
My husband don't go. I'm going now.
Oh.
I got CDC.
Oh. You can get bored, don't worry. This is just the overture, just the
beginning. I know you, but you still haven't seen it. We need to land them one. You gotta walk with me.
Long, 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 long.
Are you ready? I already.
Yeah, I don't worry. It's not too late. We can get both, man. Big and Terry's must have both.